visionary. He gives him a vision. So the key thing is we cannot worry about seeing it. We just have to follow the glory that rests upon him. And see, if you follow the glory that rests upon him, watch this, even though I don't believe, even though I can't see it, those blessings that are on him will come on me. I bet you've been around people that were had it all together. Just because you're around them, good things happen. You didn't understand it right. You didn't have it all together, but you followed them and good things happened. So I'm telling you, follow the man of God. Touch your neighbor by the hand. Tell him to follow the man of God. Because the anointing is on him. It's on him. A lot of times God has wondrous things in store for us. And one thing you don't want to do, in order to get to the promised land, because there's another side of the story that we didn't go into. It was 40 years. And a lot of those who started out didn't go. Because God had to put some of them to sleep. Because of disobedience. Watch yourself. Yeah, I know it's got a little quiet in here now. People who did not want to listen. Watch this. People who because this is how rebellion starts in the camp. Stops as we come here. Sorry. Just had a meeting with Pastor. You know what, Doc? Just had a meeting with Pastor. You know, I think Pastor losing his mind. Man, Pastor talking about, man, I come here and do my work every day and yet still is not good enough. Man, he ain't right. You know, just like every other preacher and every other thing like that. Man, we got to, You see that truck he got? Oh, he living too large. I think he getting beside himself. I think we got to do something about that. They begin to murmur against Moses. They begin to complain.
Yes, they did.
And they forgot that Moses was the one who brought them out. Hey, don't forget that Williams was the one that helped you to get over. It's easy once you get past the situation and you get on Blessing Boulevard to forget, but don't forget to remember where all the blessings are. And then some of us get lazy. Here we are. Hey, we don't want to do anything. I just want to come out of my apartment up here and come down here and get something to eat. What they got to eat today? Ain't thinking about work. Don't want to work. Come down here any old kind of way and get something here. The children of Israel got like that because God began to provide quail for them to eat. Quail is a small fish. They didn't have to fish for it. They didn't have to go anywhere. He just provided for it. He just let it. They just get up in the morning and it was there. But do you not know that they forgot where their blessings were coming from? And they started complaining about the quail. But then God got tired of that. And he said, I tell you what, y'all so ungrateful. You want something to eat? Here it is. He gave them so much quail that they began to regurgitate the quail. It began to come out their eyes and their nose and every hole they had, and they died. blessings come from. When you praise God and when you thank God, then God can do some things with you. God can open some doors like never before. Hey, but who you gonna tell somebody, tell your neighbor real quick, I won't forget where my blessings come from. Because I want to be one of the ones to make it to the promised land. I want to make it to the promised land. I'm going to make it to the promised land. Hey, my God. Your promised land. God is a type. We're talking about the promised land of Canaan. But the Lord has a spiritual promised land for you. How many have been in Lake Ridge ministry over 10 years? Stand up. Look at that 10-year alumni. Give them a hand. How many have been here at least, you can be seated. How many have been here at least 5 years? Look at God. How many have been here at least 2 years? Come on, look at God. And then how many have been here for at least a couple months? At least a couple months ago. Look at God. Look at what God is doing. Just take a minute real quick. Just take a minute. Go back to that real dark hour and period in your life when there was no Lake Ridge. And remember the first day God sent you here. Oh my God. That's a good place to praise him right there. He puts you in good hands. You can be seated. You can be seated. He puts you in good hands. My. Your success or the value of anything that you have depends on the hands of whose it's in. Tell somebody the success or the value of what you have depends upon whose hands it's in. You got to make sure it's in the right hands. Yeah, this ministry is in the right hands. Because listen, a football. Yeah, come on, brother musician, y'all help me out. A football in my hands is only worth $30. But a football in Reggie Wilson's hands is worth $77 million. It depends upon whose hands gets in. A baseball in my hands is only worth $65. But a baseball in Miguel Cabrera's hands is worth $150,000. A basketball, even though I used to play, is only worth about $60 in my hands. But in LeBron James' hands, it's worth $250,000. A tennis racket in my hands. You put it in my hands, I might be able to hit it over the net, and I might not. But you put it in Sabrina Williams' hands, it'll get you a Wimbledon cup. My God. Yeah, a peanut in my hands. Well, it's a smack. That's all I can do with it to eat. But a peanut in George Washington Carver's hands. You got peanut butter, you got peanut oil, and you got 1,000 other inventions. A ruler in my hand. I can make a straight line, but you put it in Benjamin Banneker's hand. It gives you the layout of Washington, D.C. My God. Hey, you put a trumpet in my hand. I can't play like that, brother. You get a bunch of noise on the trumpet, but you put the trumpet in Joshua's hand. He was blowing him down, came the wall. It's my hands. streams, if you would. Ah, come on, give God some praise. Give Him some praise. Listen, just worship Him. We praised Him earlier. And I told you, praise is what you do to get in the presence of God. And once you're in the presence of God, you begin to worship. We're in His presence now. We're in the inner sanctum now. We're in the throne room now. We're in a place of worship. We're in a place of worship. Listen, this is your time to not miss your blessing. You miss your purpose. You miss where the Lord would have you be. But tell Him, Lord, I'm tired of missing. I'm tired of messing up. I'm not going to miss anymore. I see what the Lord is doing in Lake Ridge and how He's blessing Lake Ridge and what He's doing through this powerful couple, this man and woman of God. I thank God for sending Lake Ridge into my life. It changed my life. And Lord, not only did it change my life, but it saved my life. How many of you believe that there's an anointing on this man of God? Pastor Williams, if you don't mind, come on down. First Lady Williams, come on down. Stand next to him. How many know that just face your people? Face your people. Bring it down just a little bit. How many know that there's an anointing that rests on this couple's life and that they've been a blessing to you? And God is taking them somewhere. I know so. And I know that this is no make-believe, this couple, this love that they have. Because when I got over there, all he could say, listen, Doc, I'm in my office now. But I got to get First Lady over here. We got to get, once we get First Lady over here, some things are going to start happening. And he told him, Brother Ray, get in that office in there. Stop fixing things. Didn't he tell you that? He got a group of men and then they began to clean out First Lady's office. Then he said, their office is next to First Lady. For Kim, get her secretary together. Because when we get in here, some things are going to happen. Let me tell you, when I was here back in November, I told you, I said that you're in this building physically, but spiritually God is taking you somewhere else. That was back in November. This building, this move was nowhere in sight. And here we stand in the month of April, getting ready to go in May. And in less than 8 months, look what God has done. Don't miss this. That same prophecy that God has given that has come to pass. If you want in on this, you better come on. I tell you, there's an anointing. There's an anointing that rests on this man's life. That anointing. Bring it out just a little bit. That anointing that he was talking about earlier today, he said, I feel an anointing when he walked in. I feel an anointing when he walked in. But the anointing.